students.
Good morning.
How are you feeling in a dark room? Are you able to see everything clearly?
Yes.
If I will write anything on the board, can you copy it right
no.
now?
No.
Why? What we need to see?
Light.
Yes, because to see anything we need
light.
Yes, now there will be light in the room and you will be able to see everything around you in clear clarity. So our topic is light and
shadow.
So our today's topic is light and
shadow.
So you will learn about different properties of light in this topic. So our today's learning outcomes will be, so after this class you will be able to differentiate luminous and non-luminous objects. Okay? And the second, you will be able to classify the objects into transparent translucent and opaque. And the third is, you can explain the formation of shadow. So these are the three learning outcomes of today's class. So firstly, we will study about the luminous and non-luminous objects. So luminous means any object which emits their own light, which has their own light. So during daytime, you can see the different objects in your surroundings. So which is the natural source present in the daytime?
Sun.
Yes, it is the sun. That is the natural source of light which is present during the daytime. And which are the sources of light during the night time? Raise your hands. Yes, beta. Yes, Namish, you tell.
Stars.
Yes, yes, you.
Moon.
Yes, stars and moon. But the star is having their own light. So stars are also luminous objects. But the moon that you have learned in the 5th class also, the moon is non-luminous object. Why the moon is non-luminous object? Anyone knows?
Okay.
Yes.
Ma'am, because the moon reflects the light that produced by the sun.
Okay. Because moon is not having its own light, it reflects only sun's light. So the moon is not a luminous object, it is a non-luminous object. Okay. So have you seen a bird, firefly, which emit light in the night time?
Yes.
Yes. So that also emit their own light, that is also a luminous object. Luminous object. And during night time or at under your room, that which is the source of light which you use to illuminate your room, to light up your room? Yes, which objects?
Bulb.
Okay.
LED lights.
Yes.
Tube light.
Very good. These are the different sources of light which we use in our home. So we will now see a video on it, in which luminous and non-luminous objects will be shown to you. Okay, and you will classify the objects luminous into luminous and non-luminous objects.
That objects which emit light of their own are called luminous objects. And those which do not emit light of their own are called non-luminous objects. Observe the following objects and mark them as luminous or non-luminous.
Yes, sun is luminous or non-luminous?
Luminous!
Okay, now we will submit it. Yes.
That's right. The sun is a luminous object as it gives out its own light.
Next, observe the following object and mark them as luminous. It's non-luminous.
That's right. The moon is a non-luminous object as it does not give out light of its own. That's right. A star is a luminous object as it gives out its own light.
Yes, is it luminous or
non-luminous?
Non-luminous.
Object as it does not give out light of its own. That's right. Water is non-luminous as it does not give out light of its own.
Yes. Yes, grass.
That's right. Fire is luminous as it gives out its own light.
Paper.
Non-luminous.
That's right. Paper is a non-luminous object as it does not give out light of its own.
Smoke.
Non-luminous.
That's right. Smoke is non-luminous and it does not give out light of its own.
Lamp.
Luminous.
Yes, it's luminous. Shooting star.
Luminous.
Planet.
Non-luminous.
That's right. A planet is a non-luminous object. It does not give out light of its own, but rather.
Glass.
Non-luminous.
Firefly.
Luminous.
That's right. A firefly is a luminous object as it gives out its own light.
Burning matchstick.
Luminous.
Yes, it's luminous. Okay, now you can see the different objects which are luminous and
non-luminous.
Now you can classify the different objects from your surroundings into two categories, which are the luminous and
non-luminous.
Okay. So next. Next we will classify the different objects according to their passage of light. Okay, so now you will see the source of light is there, that is the torch, and I will pass it through the different materials and you will see the light is passing through it or not. Now you can see.
Yes.
The light is completely passing through it.
Yes.
Yes, the materials which allow the light to pass through it completely, these materials are called transparent materials. And one more example is there.
No.
Are you able to see the light clearly?
Yes.
So such objects are called transparent objects. Next.
No.
Are you able to see the light from the other side?
No.
So this type of objects which do not allow the light to pass through it are called opaque objects. opaque objects. Okay? So like this, you are not able to see the light from the other side. So these type of objects are called
opaque objects.
So take one more example. We will see is the light is passing completely or not. Yes, light is passing partially, not completely. So these type of objects are called translucent objects. These are called translucent objects. Okay. So there are three types of objects in our surroundings. Which objects you see and you can put it in front of the light and you can see the light is passing through it completely, partially or not passing through it. So we will divide these objects into three categories: transparent, translucent and opaque objects. Okay, is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, now we will play a game on it.
Thanks for volunteering to help find missing document from the National Science Archives. Investigators believe that the document is hidden here in this tunnel, in a treasure chest. Many of them have tried to get to it, but have not been successful because of the many challenges faced inside. But I am sure you will be able to do it. Are you ready? Click start when you are ready to enter the tunnel.
This gate you can open only to find any green objects of this particular kind.
Yes, you have to find out three transparent objects.
You have to identify three transparent objects. Look around and find them. You may test an object by holding it in front of a light source to see how clear it is. Click objects to test and select or reject them. Click submit when you are done.
Here we have to, if we have any doubt, then you can put the object in front of the light. Light is there, na?
Yes.
You can put the object in front of the light and you can see if the light is passing through it completely. Then it will be transparent object.
Yes.
So you have to find out three transparent objects. Okay?
You did get them all right. Please try again.
No. These all are not transparent. This lens will be transparent?
Yes.
Just have four more barriers to overcome.
Yes, now the gate is open.
Ah, I see you have overcome the first barrier easily. I am more tough, just like you will see. answer my question, and you better get this right. What kind of object would allow some light?
Yes, Gagab.
Choose the correct option and click submit.
What kind of object would allow some light?
Transmitted.
Yes.
Great. You just have 3 more barriers to overcome.
Next, we will study about the different properties of light. So, can you see the source of light is here?
Yes.
And the straight pipe is there. Okay. So, you can see. Yes. Can you see the light from the other side?
Yes.
Yes. So, this shows the light travels in a straight line. Because this pipe is straight, so the light is moving from it, and light can move straight line. In straight. And if I will bend this pipe, now you can see. If I will bend this pipe in the center, so now are you able to see the light from the other side?
No.
Are you able? No.
No.
Yes. This shows light always travels in a straight line. Path of the light is straight always. So it cannot bend its path. So whenever any opaque object is in the path of the light, like if light is moving in the straight line, and if any opaque object in the path of the light, and it forms a
shadow.
It forms a shadow. Yes. Can you see the shadow of this ball?
Yes.
Shadow. Okay. Like we are having this glass also. Opaque object. Can you see the shadow?
Yes.
Yes. And shadow is always of opaque object. Opaque object forms the shadow. Okay? For formation of shadow, we require 3 things: source of light, opaque object, and the screen on which the shadow will be formed. Screen. So that wall or ground, it will be act like a screen. Yes, you must have seen your shadow when you are in the sunlight. Have you seen your shadow?
Yes.
And what is the color of the shadow?
Yes.
Whatever the color of the object, but shadow is always of
black.
Okay. So now you can see the shadow. Shadow is not always of same size of the object. Size of the shadow will be changed. It depends on the source of position of the source of light. If it is close to the object, the shadow will be bigger, larger. Okay? Now you can see. If I will decrease the distance, the shadow will be become a shorter. Yes. Can you see? Yes. Are you able to find? According to the position of the object, the shadow size of the shadow will be changed. So same. In the mid time of the day, the sunlight is our overhead, so our shadow will be shorter. But in the evening time or in the early morning time, the shadow will be of our body will be larger. So have you observed this? Sometimes our shadow will be of larger size. Okay, and it will be on the other side of the object. If the source of light is on the this side, the shadow will be on the other side. Shadow will be always of the on the other side of the object. Okay? So now we will see a video on it. To revise this topic, so now we will see a video on it. So watch it carefully.
Stand outside on a sunny day, you will see your shadow. When you get in the way of the light from the sun, you block the light and a shadow is formed. Have you ever noticed that your shadow changes? When the sun is high in the sky during midday, it is directly overhead and your shadow is short.
Yes, have you seen it?
Now look at this shadow. This person's shadow is much longer. Why is it so long? Well, your shadow is...
Why is it so long? The shadow is so long now. Why? What's the reason for it? Because the position of the light is on the... not on the overhead. It is on the side. Similarly, it happened to us. Okay? In the early morning or early evenings.
Long when the sun is low in the sky. For example, in the early morning or in the early evening. As the sun appears to move across the sky, your shadow will change length throughout the day. When you move, so will your shadow. It will always be on the side that faces away from the sun.
Shadows are not in the front, but they are to the side.
Can you work out which direction the sunlight is coming from? This person's shadow is also to the side. Can you work out which direction the sunlight is coming from now?
Yes.
The person's shadow is...
Can you find out in which direction, from which direction sunlight is coming from? From the other side?
Yes.
Yes, the shadow is on the different side.
Also quite short in length. What time of the day you think it is? If the shadow is short.
Yes, if the shadow is of short size, short, then what time of the day will be? Which time of the day will be?
Afternoon.
Yes, very good. It's afternoon. It's a midday. During the midday, the sun is at the overhead, in the center.
Watch these soldiers carefully as they march. Can you identify what changes about their shadows?
Yes, observe the shadow. As they change the position, the shadow goes.
Remember, our shadows always stay with us. Our shadows can change direction. They can be in front or behind us, or even to the side of us. Our shadows can change in length too. They are short during midday and long in the early morning or evening. Now, let's do a small activity to check how the shadow of an object on Earth changes due to a change in the sun's position.
According to the position of the sun, the shadow is changing?
Yes.
Yes. Look at this. Yes. During the midday, the sun is at the overhead and the shadow will be shorter. Yes. Again, when the sun is on the other side, the shadow is also becoming bigger. Yes. Yes. Is it clear to everyone now?
Yes.
Okay. So let's check your knowledge. What you have learned till now. Okay? Yes. So now there will be quiz for you. Shadow change throughout the day. As you observed in the video, this size of the shadow is changing. So why does the size of the shadow will be changed during the throughout the day? Yes.
During the position of sun.
Yes, due to the position of the sun. Because the size of the shadow depends on the size, the position of the source of light. So during the day, the source of light is the sun. So it's according to the position of that. So next is the dash will not cast a shadow when placed in the path of light. Yes. Yes, very good. Clap for her. Transparent object will not cast a shadow. Which object will cast a shadow?
Opaque.
Because opaque object blocks the path of the light, so that form a shadow. But the transparent object allows the light to pass through it, so it does not create shadow. Okay? Next question. What will be the direction of your shadow when the sun is in front of you? Yes. Yes. The shadow. What will be the direction of the shadow? It will be at your back. When the sun is in the front, the shadow will be at the back. Because shadow is always on the other side of the source of light. Next. What are the requirements for the shadow formation? We need three things to form the shadow. So what are the three requirements for the shadow formation? Yes.
Source of light, opaque object and a screen.
Very good. Clap for him. We need three things to form a formation of shadow. That is source of light, opaque object and a screen. Screen may be wall or it may be ground. Next. Which of the shadow of a person would be at the shortest at dash? Yes, last one.
At midday.
At
midday of the day.
Midday, yes. At midday and in the afternoon, the shadow will be at the shortest of the sides. What will be the reason of it? Who can tell? Why shadow is of shortest side during the daytime? Midday. Because? Yes.
Because the sun is overhead.
Yes, very good. Because sun is at the overhead. So it makes shorter shadow. Okay. Next, we observe dash when the path of light is obstructed by an opaque object. When there is opaque object in the path of the light, we observe, yes, Himanshu.
Shadow.
Yes, we observe a
shadow.
Okay. When is a shadow formed? When is a shadow formed? What is the condition when the shadow is formed?
When the opaque object comes in the path of the light.
Very good. Clap for her. When the opaque object comes in the path of the light, then shadow is formed. Okay. What is the color of the shadow?
Black.
Yes.
Black.
Yes. The color of the shadow is always of
black.
Whatever the color of the object, but shadow is always black color. Yes. Now, at what time of the day will the shadow of a tree in an open field will be smallest in size? Smallest shadow. When the shadow will be of a tree, it is the smallest. At which time of the day? Yes.
Midday.
Yes. That we have already done. In the midday, the shadow will be of smallest size. Next, the sun is on the position of which side of? You can see the picture. And now, in this picture, at which side the shadow sun will be? Yes, beta. Last one. Yes, because shadow is in the right side, so the object will be in the, source of light is on the
left
side. Okay. When will be the shadow of a tree in an open field be the longest in size? When the shadow will be the longest in size?
Yes. At evening?
Yes, at evening or in the early morning. During both times. During early morning and during early evening. Okay. Next up, student, observe the shadow of a pen by holding it in the flame with a brightly lit candle on a table. In front of a candle or a torch, you can see the shadow of a pen. The shadow is formed on a screen opposite to the candle. If the student blows off the candle, then what will be happen to the shadow of the pen? If there will be no candle, he will blow off the candle. Then what will happen to the shadow?
The shadow will be disappearing.
Yes, very good. Clap for it. Shadow will be disappearing. Because for the formation of shadow, we require source of light. Okay. So, now check all the learning outcomes will be clear to you.
Yes.
Are you able to find out the luminous and non-luminous objects?
Yes.
Classify. You can classify the different objects from your surroundings into three categories.
These are transparent, translucent and opaque objects. And third, you can explain the formation of shadow. How the shadow is formed. So now you will revise all these topics and I will take your test tomorrow. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Well,